In this video, we're doing a deep dive into one of the most important topics if you want a relationship to work. We're talking about masculine and feminine energies. And they're not what you think. We'll get to that in a minute. And man, do we got some good visuals today. Look at that 45-minute artwork that I just catered for the beautiful people like yourself at home watching. Now, whether you're single or in a relationship, you wanna make it better, you gotta know this. If you're single, you want your best shot at attracting someone who's like, man, this is the person of my dreams. You better know this stuff. This video is gonna have three parts, okay? The very first one is down here. I'll explain these three concepts that you need to know if you're like, masculine, feminine energy, what is that? The second part is we'll explain even further what the heck those two things are. And then the third part of this video are just gonna be some balancing forces at play. Okay, so why does he act that way when I'm in a relationship with him? Or why do all guys have that pattern? I know some people are getting ready to type some comments down there. Chill out. This video has nothing to do with sexual orientation, with gender, with roles. Okay, we're gonna explore how these both energies you have. Okay, men, women, straight relationships, other relationships, they all have them. These are the dynamics at work. In fact, that's our first one of the key things down here. You're like, what the heck is this? Let me tell you, the concept of polarity. This is not a new concept. In fact, you can see it in many walks of your life. There's up, down, east, west, on, off, hot, cold, and masculine and feminine. Neither is weaker, neither is stronger, neither is better, neither is less. They're just different. In other words, you need the light to appreciate the dark. How do you know north if you don't know south? How do you know up if there's no down? This is where that saying that opposites attract come from. You're not attracted to someone who hates everything that you love. That's a terrible relationship right there. Would you want to go out on a date with that person? Hey, watch this movie last night. It was one of my all-time favorites. You better stop talking right now. I hate that movie. This is because you're attracted to your polar opposite here. The 80-20 principle comes into play with this. That about, you know, if you're a man, you probably have 80% masculine energy, which again, we'll deep dive on, and 20% feminine energy, okay? And if you're a woman, you probably have 80% feminine energy, 20% masculine energy. Now, these vary person to person, relationship to relationship, super varying degrees right here. You know a lot of really feminine guys, right? Even straight guys that just have more of a feminine energy to them. And guess what they end up with? A really masculine style woman who's more decisive, who has all these other traits we'll get into here. And the opposites attract, it works. Even in non-heterosexual couples, a lot of times these energies are still at play. In other words, you are directly attracted to your counterpart that completes you, okay? And just like a magnet, has two sides, and the more polar opposite, that's a stronger attraction right there, it's a stronger charge. That's how you're kind of wired. I have a pretty even split here. I'm not the most like macho dude. I've never been super competitive, right? But when it comes to business, when it comes to focus, when it comes to mission, that's where my masculine traits are channeled. But I've learned so much through being around women, the women in my life, even my mom, my sister, my grandma, the women I've dated, been in long-term relationships with, they teach you so much because that's not what you are, and the opposites attract. The counter is what attracts you. Last thing here is to understand that nature is always in balance. It's always fighting back towards homeostasis. Even global disasters, that's nature in a way getting back to balance there. What happens if you're attracted to someone who's not the perfect 20 to your 80 and vice versa, right? Well, then that's where the interesting dynamic comes in, okay? And you're always trying to get to that perfect like groove right there of, okay, where's the energy in this? And it needs to balance it out. So sometimes this will happen. You got a guy with a really masculine energy, gets in a relationship with a woman with a very masculine energy, and they'll butt heads because that's not always compatible. And so they'll be kind of duking it out, normally in arguments and stuff. And so what happens? Sometimes in relationships, you abandon your energy and you conform to meet the other person's. And that's actually kind of dangerous because freedom, being free and true to yourself, it's always a higher need than love. If you've seen our other relationship videos, you know that, right? No one wants to be controlled. No one wants to be possessed. No one wants to be dominated over, right? And that's why understanding this, you understand why the other person is wired the way they are, right? and you can kind of work on that and see it for the first time. All right, so moving in, let's get specific here. Let's talk about feminine and masculine energy. This is part two. Let's really deep dive. Let's start with the masculine first. Now, the masculine is much more left-brained traditionally, right? The masculine energy operates from I think. The feminine energy, on the other hand, is much more right-brained, operates predominantly from I feel. And now, this is where neuroscience comes in. Your brain has two hemispheres, right? Left and right. The left hemisphere is much more logic, reasoning, decisiveness, all that stuff, thinking. The right side is the creativity, is, you know, where all the arts are, okay? Those centers light up. When you're smelling a rose, it's normally on that side, right? So it's much more feeling. How cool is that? Right there is polarity in and of itself. Feminine energy is much more creative, flowing, nurturing, caring, intuitive, community focused. Masculine energy is much more linear. Here's point A, there's point B, gonna go on this path, right? Just straight to it. Drive, focus, compete, competitive, practical, and strategic. Another way to look at this, binary and polarity here, is the masculine thinks very much more outward. Where am I going? Where, you know, how am I getting there? Point A, point B, I see it, I go. The feminine energy is much more inward. It's feeling, like a lot of that stuff is more intuitive. So that was just the overview. Now let's go deeper into a few examples of what happens if this is balanced, if this is imbalanced. And again, to recap where we're at here, we all have a masculine and a feminine energy, just like there are two sides of the coin. There's night and day, there's up and down. You have that within you. You're always attracted to your counterpart, right? Proportionately, that kind of completes you in that way that opposites attract. And that this is always in balance or fighting to achieve balance. And that's where a lot of the conflicts in relationships come from, is not understanding this. Most masculine people suffer in relationships because they don't understand how to dance with the feminine energy. This is why, you know, guys with masculine energy like to just hang around each other. They're just chilling with the bros, kind of an escape from the dance of it. It's like if people are speaking Chinese and you speak English, well, you know, even if you understand a little bit, it's nice to just go somewhere where you speak your own native language, isn't it? So a story on this and an example on this to make this more practical for you is, I remember in my last relationships, I would always try and fix when she would come with a problem. I was the fixer, right? She'd come home, long, stressful day at work, talking about how her boss doesn't respect her, coworkers are awful, blah, blah, blah. And so I'm sitting there and I'm really quick. Well, why don't you quit? Why don't you talk to them about it? Why don't they listen? You should go find another job, right? Fix, 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 solution, solution. Then one day she's like, Clark, I don't need you to coach me. This was me in my early 20s, right? I was like, what? Why not? I read all these books. I have 300 books and blah, blah, blah. She's like, I just want you to listen. I'm like, why are we having this conversation in the first place if you just want to talk and you want me to listen? My masculine energy wanted to fix. Linear, A, B, everything looks like a nail, I have a hammer, let me whack it. But her feminine energy just wanted to change her feeling. She wanted to change her mood, not her mind. Now that's powerful right there. Dudes, if you're in a relationship with a woman who has a feminine energy, change her mood, not her mind, that one little saying there, it's gonna save you a few fights, let me tell you. This was in a book I was reading too. It's like, never try to fix your woman because she doesn't want that. And another thing that came from it too, this is great advice that I've always applied, is that, and again, you know, there's exceptions to all these, but in these videos, I'm not gonna preface everything for 20 seconds, it just gets exhausting. So just understand my intention with this is just to give you the best stuff that works. The saying goes, men, how they grow, it's very different than how women grow, okay? Masculine energies respond differently than feminine energies. And that men grow through challenge. Okay, growing up, men compete. Hey dude, bet you can't jump over that fence. Then later it turns into, dude, bet you 10 bucks you won't go up and ask that girl out, right? Bet you 10 bucks you can't do this. Men are competing always. That's the masculine energy in, you know, how it manifests. Sometimes men are like, well, my dad told me this one thing when I was a kid, and so I'm gonna prove him wrong, right? That like style of motivation there, that prove them wrong motivation, that's a competitive form. You know, I'm gonna prove my ex-girlfriend wrong and start Facebook. Mark Zuckerberg right there, right? So men are always going through competition. They're growing through challenge. The feminine energy grows through praise. Okay, remember, change her mood, not her mind. Praising your woman, praising her freely. That's how you get the feminine energy to really grow and feel supported. So if you're in a relationship, right, fixing, what is that? That's a challenge, right? Praising, what is that? That's her mood. So see how the masculine and the feminine operates on defaults there and why there's so much relationship conflict like that. Look, just go to Instagram and choose any two influencers. Go to the dude's account who's like a bodybuilder. Look at his comments. You know, you'll see like, dude, looking good, looking jacked, right? You'll hear things like huge, jacked, big. Guys ragging on each other when they show up. Hey, dude, looking small. Are you sure you're still going to the gym? Looking kind of small, buddy. What's going on? Skip leg day? That's the challenge at play. The feminine energy, go to their comments. Gorgeous, knockout, slay, queen, just all praise from girls. That's how they respond. One other point that's very important for women, or if you have a predominantly feminine energy, a lot of women try to change their man into more feminine, right? Because they're like, can you be more like me? And you could say vice versa too, but it's rare on the other end. Like women are going to guys like, I want him to be more sensitive. I want him to open up. I want him to blah, blah, blah. And that's good if you're striving for balance here, right? If he's imbalanced and not communicating, that's one thing. Okay, so what happens? Maybe the guy caves and he starts going towards the middle, right? Or even swinging on the feminine side. She's actually going to miss that masculine energy, right? And so she'll say one thing, but kind of mean another in that sense there, where she says she wants you to almost, her communications, right? There's like, be like a woman, be more feminine. But if you do, and you go so far over there, she'll stop actually being attracted to you because that polarity is gone. Sometimes women are also attracted to some of these traits here. The drive, the focus, the competitive nature, the linear, the strategic, the practical, right? Or sometimes it's funny, like I've been in relationships and what attracted them to me, right? Well, we'd have to ask her, but she'd probably agree with this, is like, Clark, you're so ambitious. That's one I heard a lot. Oh, you're so such a hard worker, right? Like the way you run this business and like you put so much time into this, even a Saturday right now, they're attracted to that, right? And they brag about it. But then 6 months in, what's the thing they're ragging on you for? Are you serious? You're working on Saturday? Oh, all you care about is work, right? So balance there. It is funny though how sometimes the things you're attracted to about the person in this stage right here of where it's like polarity, your first meeting, right? Eventually starts to almost repel you. Let's look at this too. Remember, we talked briefly about how balancing forces are always at play here and that these always need to remain like a homeostatic balance between, you know, everything. Globally, as a consciousness, it's said that we're a very, well, actually, let me ask you, what do you think we are globally? You know, are we a very feminine society or a very masculine society? Look at the current state of the world. We're a very masculine society, right? We don't get along very well. We're blowing stuff up. War dominates, right? So most of the problems in the world right now are coming from an over masculine society. And so that's why conversations like this, videos like this, you know, my whole channel is definitely more, I'd say it's more balanced, but definitely in terms of self-development, you know, it's right here in the middle, leaning towards the feminine side. Typically masculine guys, they're not seeking out, you know, how to do shadow work, right? If you are, that means you're balanced in the middle and you're integrated, which is awesome. But they're going to like business content who drop some, you know, self-development advice, and that's how they get it. I don't want to touch that spiritual stuff, right? And I get it, that's how I was early on too. It was only when I checked myself and said, whoa, the other side of the coin there, you know, you have like the East and the West, the Eastern spiritual camp right here, which is all like manifest and, you know, subconscious mind and meditating and slowing down, right? And being happy and present and grounded versus the Western self-development over here has a very masculine charge to it, doesn't it? Earn more in your business, right? How to, you know, get followers online, all this stuff, right? Productivity, get more done, goals, you know, how to wake up at 5 a.m. That's all masculine drive right there. Now that's good for like linear success or building a business, right? But that'll just leave you depleted and drained because you're not in balance here, right? You following this? So back to the current state of our world. Where do you think that is right now? It's very masculine, okay? And imbalance too. And so how are we going to change it? You know, with more of this, more competitive, more crushing. I'm not going political. I'm not going with hot button issues here. We keep it pretty like vanilla on this channel. No one wants to hear my politics, especially not my girlfriend, but she hears them anyway. I've always approached it like, I don't care what you believe. I don't care, you know, whatever. If you're here, you know, we get along, we're friends. Some people are talking about toxic masculinity. You hear that word a lot, right? Or that phrase a lot, that it's men who mess everything up and men are so bad and men do all the wars and men do all the crimes and men. So naturally, the natural conclusion of that is like, okay, well then men are the problem. And I don't think that's true at all. I think an imbalance of masculine energy is the problem. And I think a lack of role models that have an integrated masculine and feminine energy, right? That's what they need. Masculinity is not the problem. It's almost a lack of it that is. If we were really balanced, everyone too, you'd have a much better society. You'd raise better children and the future would change. And so for you, practically here, you know, if you feel like you're more here and less here, explore the other side. It's going to help your relationship, but more importantly, it's going to help you. And why I say more importantly is because where do all relationships start? How can you give love if you don't have it for yourself? How can you attract the 10 if internally you're not a 10, right? If you're not giving the best of you, what's really the reason for them to stay around? It's going to get exhausting after a couple years, right? You can only love someone so much, but if you're carrying them for their whole life, I mean, no one's going to, that's unfair too. Relationships are a place you go to give, not a place you go to get. And so when you recognize these in yourself, you can work on it. You can balance it out. And it's okay, too, if you're in this camp of like, wow, I'm overly feminine. Maybe take on some of this. Same with the dudes out there, right? I'm overly masculine. Take on some of that. Balance it out. Again, all relationships start with you. So if you're looking to create the best version of yourself so you can make relationships awesome, so you can attract one, right? So you can get the best shot at like attracting the person that you know you deserve, click down below. Check out our application for our metamorphic coaching program. We talk about how to create the 2.0 version of yourself. Really raise yourself up and shift into that. So it's not fake or vague. It's just a natural state of being of who you are. And that's a 6-week process. I'm working with you personally, one-on-one, every single day for 6 weeks. You got me in your corner there. So that, I love doing it. Love working with our students over there. The really cool community too. We get together as a small group and we talk about ideas like this. So that's in the link below. Let me know what you think. And until next time, stop settling, start living.